Hi! The purpose of this video is to introduce you to our R2-40 rotating assembly. This was specifically designed for vertical axis wind turbines and also designed for our wind razor family of wind turbine wings. It is sold as a kit with all of the parts precisely machined and fabricated. See the website for a complete list of all of the items included. You'll need to make the stator yourself, which is not included, and you will also need magnets. The robust design is based on our 1,000-pound axle and hub. This uses precision roller bearings for high performance and trouble-free operation, even in extreme conditions. The first step is to weld the spindle to the spindle plate. This is then reinforced with an additional bushing. All of the welding should be done by an expert. Now we can use this to hold our work as we assemble it. Slide a bearing in place, then the hub with the studs facing up. Then bolt the upper spoke flange onto the hub and tighten the lug nuts. The next step is to add the spokes with their spacers and the lower spoke flange. In general, we advise to use a quality thread locking compound on all of the fasteners throughout the assembly. It is helpful to leave the bolts finger tight until all of the spokes are installed. Then tighten everything up. Find the 1/4-inch threaded rod. We're going to cut this into studs that are approximately 1 3/8 inches long. When cutting them, be sure not to damage the threads. Apply a drop of thread locking compound, then screw these into the lower spoke flange. These studs are used to mount the magnet discs. Now find the piece of 3/8 diameter aluminum tubing. This will be cut into short sections that will be used as spacers in between the magnet discs. The spacers should be 1 1/4 inches long. Cut these as accurately as possible, assuring that they are all the same length. Now put the stator in place. For details on how to make the stator, see our other tutorial videos. Stack several wooden blocks on top of the stator. These will be used to support the second magnet disc. The magnetic attraction between the discs is extremely strong and can cause injury. Never let your fingers get trapped in between them. One at a time, carefully remove each wooden block until the disc is lowered down on the studs and is firmly resting on the spacers. Then install the nuts, tighten them, and lift the entire assembly up off of the spindle. The kit includes a matching flange plate, which is welded on top of your tower. Bolt the spindle and stator bracket to the top of your tower. Now find the piece of 3/8 inch diameter threaded rod and cut this into sections that are approximately 4.5 inches long. Mount them onto the stator bracket with the nuts and washers provided. These studs are used to mount and adjust the position of the stator. Okay. The tapered roller bearings are then packed with a quality general purpose bearing grease. This is a messy job, so be prepared to get your hands dirty. Slide the lower bearing onto the spindle. Then add the main assembly. Make sure that the mounting holes in the stator line up with the studs. Install the top bearing, then the castle nut. Tighten it finger tight, then back it off until the first slot aligns with the cross hole in the shaft. Insert the cotter pin, then bend the legs over. Then finish mounting the stator into place and adjust it so that it is centered between the magnet plates. Finally, install the grease cap and the assembly is complete. Well, we hope this video was helpful. Keep an eye on our website for upcoming videos, and thank you for watching.